Welcome friends, I am Tonmoy. Today we are going to discuss, means a comparative study you can say, between hydroboration, oxidation and oxymercuration, demarcation. What is the need of this video? Actually this hydroboration and oxymercuration, demarcation result in the same product. But ultimately their path is little different, their process is little different. So some confusion created. So that's why I decided to make this video. Ultimately, both reactions are the conversion of double bond into an alcohol. Okay, so keep this thing in mind. So the reagent for hydroboration is first BH3, then hydroboration, and second step is the oxidation of that boron reagent to form alcohol. In case of oxymercuration, demercuration, what happens? That double bond reacts first in presence of mercury to salt, mainly mercury acetate. Okay, in presence of water, and second part, the demarcation process happened in presence of NaBH4. Okay, and that results in another alcohol. So from these two product, I believe you can guess it is different. This is primary alcohol, this is secondary alcohol. Okay, so this overall reaction indicates their nature. For example, here the water addition is anti-Merkovnikov. Why? In case of here hydrogen added and here hydroxyl. Okay, so according to Merkovnikov's rule, negative part of the addendum will attach to that carbon which is poorer in hydrogen. But here negative part oxygen is attached to that carbon which are not poor, rich in hydrogen. So that is, it is anti-Merkovnikov product. Anti-Merkovnikov product. Okay. But this is Merkovnikov. Okay. I am just writing here to save time. So this is, this overall reaction is anti-Merkovnikov, but addition of BH3 is not anti-Merkovnikov. I have explained in this in my hydroboration video. I will give the link. BH3 addition is apparently looks, this overall reaction looks like anti-Merkovnikov, but BH3 addition is Merkovnikov, because in case of BH3 which is getting attached, this is negative and this is positive. But here water, this hydrogen is positive, oxygen is delta negative. So you can consider, you can understand that polarity of hydrogen here negative, polarity of hydrogen here positive. So ultimately, that's why the addition to the double bond is different here. Okay? Okay. Let's come to the second point. Second point means, here, the reaction happens through a four-member cyclic transition state. What does it mean? Let's draw the transition state. This is hydrogen. This is boron. These dotted bonds indicated that bonds which are getting broken or formed during the transition state. So this indicates it's a four-member cyclic transition state. Okay, first stage. Here, what happens? First, mercury 2+ attached to this double bond, because mercury is a Lewis acidic center, and the double bond is a ligand. It acts like that. And what happens? What they produce? R double bond coordinated to the mercury 2+. Actually, it one acetate is attached to here. And what the TS looks like? The transition state is a three-membered transition state. It's a three-membered mercurinium transition state. Mercurinium. Okay, three-membered mercurinium transition state. This is the nature. So here four member cyclic transition state, here three member cyclic transition state. Okay. So I told that in case of hydroboration, hydrogen was delta minus. That's why this hydrogen is getting attached here. Here, in case of this, water have this oxygen as delta minus. So that oxygen attacks this side and opens up the ring. So remember, in both case the nucleophile is attacking, means electron rich species is attacking, but here the nature of electron rich species is different. That's why this reaction is producing different product. This is the transition state we have explained. Right now, the nature of the reaction. Actually, both reaction produces alcohol, both, but none of these produces carbocation. No carbon plus. No carbocation is produced. No carbocation is produced, because if we check the, as a same material hydroboration, it will produce this hydroboration, this will produce this hydroxyl, and this will produce this hydroxyl. For example, this is hydroboration and this is oxymercuration, demercuration, OMDM. OMDM, it is produced this. Their regioselectivity is maintained. In case of that, it will give Merkovnikov product, this one, and this one anti-Merkovnikov. But no carbocation. If carbocation is formed, then this product would have been migrated. For example, if this alkene produces carbocation, for example, here, carbocation is here, then this migration happened and ultimately result other product, but here no migration thing is observed. This indicates that both of the reaction, none of this reaction produces carbocation as a intermediate. Now ultimate another interesting difference between them is the hydration of alkyne. Till now we were discussing about alkene, but right now we will say the difference in case of hydration of alkyne. See, for example, if we take R, C triple bond CH, terminal alkyne, here also R triple bond C, CH, what will be the product here? Here the product will be, this ultimately will produce an aldehyde, R CH2CHO. This terminal carbon is converted into this aldehyde group. This is the difference. So, but here if we do, if we say check the product is R C double bond O CH3. Here this thing, this carbon is converted into carbon, carbonyl carbon. But this terminal one is converted into CH3. The main difference, terminal to aldehyde, here terminal to ketone. This is one of the big difference. If instead of terminal, if we take internal alkyne, for example, R C triple bond C. And let's take symmetrical R. That will be ketone. Okay. And if it is not symmetrical, unsymmetrical, then it will be mixture of ketone. But here, if we check the internal, that is also ketone. And if we check R and R prime, means different, then also mixture of ketone. Okay, I guess this is the difference, and the most important means at the very common thing, this is metal free and this is metal based. Another thing is that here the first step in case of hydroboration, the second step is, here the second step is oxidation. Second step is oxidation. What? That B CH2R 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 reacts with hydrogen peroxide anion, means hydroperoxide anion, it attacks here, ultimately it attacks here, which produces this, which produces OCH2R. This ultimately this migrates and this leaves. So the second after this leaving, this process continues and ultimately produces boron ester and alcohol. So the second step is oxidation, and here the second step is reduction, because after reaction with the alkene R, here also alkene, so don't confuse, here acetylene is written, alkyne is written, here also alkene. Okay, so it reacts with mercury and ultimately produces this water, this mercury and water should be anti. This is, in the second step, reaction happens with sodium borohydride via radical mechanism, which reduces this mercury and here hydrogen attached. So second step is here the reduction. Okay, so I guess you have understood. This video will help you to keep the story in mind properly. So we'll finish this video today, and next day we will discuss about this hydration of alkene and the basic concept. I should have been explaining it earlier, but I'm sorry I couldn't explain. So I'll explain that. So, okay, thank you. And if you like my videos, please like the videos and share and comment and subscribe my channel, Chemistry, The Mystery of Molecules. So ultimately, God bless you.